What's up, everybody? Red Hammer SLA. And if you're anything like me, you're planning on getting or have already gotten yourself a copy of Blacklight Retribution, the full release, not the beta, which you see on the screen. And again, if you're like me, you're trying to get into multiplayer as fast as possible. You can kill people, you want to taste people's blood, you want to, you know, shove your fucking fingers into their wounds, you know what I'm saying, and pull them out and lick them while you stare in their fucking dead eyes, you know, or at least their dying eyes. You know, you just kind of do that little laugh at them. As you taste their blood. That's how I do it. That's how we're gonna do this little, like, secrets vid that I've got going on for you guys. Alright, I don't usually do these types of tips and tricks kind of thing, but I'm telling you, as soon as I actually modified the settings, which I feel like lots of people don't do, the game became much faster and much more manageable. Alright, you can play the game really well as long as you know, kind of tweak the settings a little bit for yourself, how you like to play, that type of thing. Alright, so we're not gonna go into multiplayer, we're gonna hit X to play! Server status. Cause that's what they do! Give it a second here. Alright. It's gonna welcome you. Bam! Or we're gonna just press circle. A mini mark comes up the store, you can buy stuff or whatever. We're not gonna get into that. Okay, we're gonna go over here, we're gonna go over to settings. Alright? And I am going to go to, let me see, hold on, I've got a Word document here, just for this, alright, the main things are the crosshair and the control. That's the two main things you want to, you know, take a look at before you actually get into multiplayer. Okay, so here's the crosshair, we're going to enter, I'm going to set them to defaults. Alright, so check this out. Yeah, I'm going to accept it. Alright, so here we go. Static crosshair, disabled. No, you want to enable that, alright? Now look, see what it says here. At the bottom left of your screen, alright? It'll actually describe what that does, alright? Displacement of crosshair from weapon spread, alright? So when you have this disabled, it makes your crosshair bloom. You don't want that because this game shoots really accurately, even from the hip, okay? So you turn that on, and now when you shoot, it doesn't bloom at all. It just stays right on target. Wonderful. Trust me, you need to do that. Smart reticule opacity. That's the thing here around your crosshair, all right? So basically, you don't need that. Basically. So I just turned mine to 4. I like to have it there a little bit, but not too much. Tick marks. You can actually change the number of tick marks. Look at that shit. I go to 4 because it's like Call of Duty. Yeah, sue me, but trust me. Much easier to manage. Tick length, look at that, 10. Ooh, so long, so nice. I like myself some 10 inches up inside it. Okay, we're gonna go to 4. Secrets. Yeah, that's what I do right there. And the crosshair opacity as well. All right, so we're gonna bump this up all the way to 10, super bright. All right, now again, this is just how I do it, so you may wanna actually do it yourself. I like all the default colors, but you can change the machine. Go to purple, you can go to fucking pink, you can go to blue, whatever, I don't know. I like the defaults, so you might like them as well. You might wanna change it up. Whatever suits you, you know? All right, so we exit out, go to control. All right, here's the next thing. We're gonna go to defaults. Yes, accept it. All right, invert look, disabled. You don't wanna, I'm not a pilot, are you a fucking pilot? So, boom, enabled. Wait, no, that's not right. Ha ha, disabled. Ooh, that was a little scary. All right, swap sticks, no. Crouch toggle, enabled. Okay, for me, I like it when I press the crouch, he stays or she stays crouched. All right, so if you don't want that, you like to actually just kind of like press it and then they crouch for a little bit and hop back up, then you disable it or whatever. Tight aim ADS, okay, so that's the ADS toggle. It comes back or leaves ADS, all right? So I've got that on disabled, all right? Because I don't want to have to press it 2 times or whatever. Aim assist, enabled, all right? You're look. I don't care that I just fucking stood there. Look! You're playing on fucking joystick. All right, maybe you're not. Maybe you've got the I don't know, adapter. I don't know if they have that for the PS4 yet for a mouse and keyboard, but you're playing on DualShock 4, you want aim assist on, all right? Some people don't like it because they think, like, it's sticky on other opponents, and that can get a little annoying, I guess, but, you know, just be more accurate with your fucking aim. You don't have to worry about it. What do I have here? Enabled, yes. That means when I hit it and I'm sprinting, it just stays sprinting. I don't have to fucking depress it or press it again and shit. All right, HRV toggle. All right, I started out this game with it enabled. It means that in order to actually get the HRV to stop, that's the thing where it allows you to see see through walls, all right? You have to press it again. But I didn't like that because I could never seem to do it as fast as possible. So now it's an enabled. So I just press it, look, and it's off, you know, and I'm off to the races. I'm killing people, you know what I'm saying? Look sensitivity, way too fucking slow. You guys, this is the big thing, okay? Look sensitivity and tight aim sensitivity, the ADS sensitivity, these are the big things, all right? And the view acceleration, of course. So this one, I bumped mine all the way up to 50. You might like it, you know, bigger than that. You might like it 100. You know, try it out. But I'm telling you, the defaults suck ass. And that's why I'm making this video. By the way, shouts to Kuzu Ranger. If you guys didn't know who he is, he's a longtime homie of mine. If you go to my main page, he's the first person on, you know, the column I say to, you know, go check out their videos. We've known each other for a long time. But he reminded me I needed to do this video. In the back of my mind, you guys, I've been thinking about doing this video for a long time, and I just didn't, all right? So, sorry. All right, anyways. But, you know, I feel like, you know, the final release, you guys need to actually have this information if you're actually going to pick it up. It's fucking free, so give it a chance. It's like Call of Duty, but it's on crack, you know, like sci-fi, cyberpunk crack. You're going to like it, as long as it works well. Okay, and this one, ADS sensitivity, I bump it up to 40. I don't like it as, you know, even 50-50, because to me, it doesn't feel like I'm going to ADS when I actually have the same sensitivity. All right, so that's why I always have it slower. I don't know, maybe most games are like that. And the view acceleration, 2.5 was too much for me, so I bumped it down to 2.0. And that's it basically. All right, so here also I will note this, okay, you guys, that the control binds, you can actually bind any function to any button on your PS4 controller. It's wonderful. That's the way it should be, in my opinion, for every goddamn FPS in the whole wide world that ever comes to, you know, to any consoles or anything, you know. It's like playing on the PC. You can actually, you know, assign functions or actions to buttons, and that should just be a default mechanism, or I don't know, system, because God, it would just make things so much easier. Mine's basically, you know, as you'll see, there's basically like Call of Duty, because this game is a Twitch shooter, so I like it, you know, playing like Call of Duty. I don't need to, you know, get creative with it. But some people, you know, they want to jump more, so they put, you know, their jump on one of the triggers, or the L1 R1 or L2 R2. And you'll notice that I've got the fire and ADS flipped from kind of standard Xboxy type shit, just because that's the way it was always on the PS3 for default settings. All right, so you may want to change that back. I might have to change it back because I broke my first PlayStation 4 controller because I was using the R1 as my fire, and I don't know, it's just kind of fucked up. So anyways, that's it. Those are all the settings, man. That's all the settings. Oh, so those are the settings. That's the secrets. All right. You need to go in there. You need to change all that stuff before you actually get into multiplayer. Because if you go into multiplayer with that, you're going to be super slow. You're going to suck balls. Ooh, it's just a terrible, terrible idea. Also, notice your default character is pretty slow, too. He's got a pretty good health, but he's really slow. So, you know, when you go in, you go to customization, and there's all the stuff you need. Oh, here. You go to custom agent. There's 1-800 laser face, and they got the helmets, and they got the armor, and they got the legs, and you need to buy this stuff or rent it or whatever, and it'll show you all the stats, how it changes it up. My guy, my woman, look at her titties. Oh, the titties! She's got a health 154, which is low, all right, but she's really fucking fast, and I like that, and she can run a lot. So, you know, whatever suits your play style. You can make a tank, you can make somebody like me who's fucking sick and beast on everybody and doing it with like a little bit of health just because you're so fucking sick at the goddamn game. You're quick. Or, you know, you can be a bitch. So you gotta choose. Yeah, anyways, hope you guys enjoyed that. Red Hat Move SLA, going through secrets. Here's a little secret, another secret for you guys. Secrets! When I was in, junior high or high school, early high school, I once masturbated for about 5 hours without actually coming because I thought it would, you know, help me with my endurance because I heard that the girls like it long. So there you go. There's a secret for you. All right, and before I go, you guys, I need to shout somebody out that without him, I wouldn't be able to make this vid. I wouldn't be able to play the game how I play it. And it's due to the fact that he did all the research on kind of what the PC guys were doing and, you know, got at me because he was excited about the game, got at me and, you know, told me about his findings. And that's Who Fucking Farted. He's a great guy, he's a funny guy, consider my friend, at least an acquaintance with friend benefits on this YouTube and Twitter shit, all right, and this game. He loves the game, or did when it was functional, much like I did. And, yeah, without him, I wouldn't have been able to play this game or showed you guys these settings or you know how to tweak them and stuff. So again, shout out to that guy. If you guys ever come through on some of the streams, you'll see that he's modded up in there. You know, talk at him in the comment section and shit. Cause yeah, like I said before, he's a funny guy. He's a good dude. So yeah, fuck you, man. Heart for all that shit. All right, I'll talk to you guys later. Red Hand Most LA. Peace the fuck out.